All NOS kits have at least one nitrous solenoid, so this section will discuss all types of kits universally as we install and connect the plumbing of the nitrous solenoids. The exception to this rule would be a dry kit setup that will have two nitrous solenoids and no fuel solenoid. If you have a dry kit, the end of this clip will deal with the nitrous regulator installation and connection instructions that are specific to NOS dry kits. If you have a wet kit, after the nitrous solenoid installation instructions, you'll be given the option to skip ahead to fuel solenoid installation details for your kit.
As mentioned, NOS dry systems usually have two nitrous solenoids, and most wet systems have one nitrous solenoid. However, many kits, such as direct port kits, will have more than one nitrous solenoid to supply the larger amounts of nitrous oxide to the engine. In most kits, there will be brackets supplied with the kit that will allow you to secure the solenoid to a convenient place near the nozzle. For all types of kits, previously, you decided on the nitrous solenoid and bracket mounting positions under the hood or along the engine. Direct port kits will not have solenoid brackets because they're supported by hardline plumbing. For all kit types, now it's time to do the permanent sealing and assembly of the nitrous solenoids.
There are three main types of plumbing fittings commonly found in NOS kits. The first is a simple threaded fitting type. These are national pipe thread pitches, commonly referred to as NPT threads. An NPT thread must have a sealant applied to prevent leakage. We highly recommend a sealant such as a Teflon paste or plumber's pipe thread sealant with a Teflon additive. As warned previously, do not use Teflon tape on NPT threads. There's too high a risk of internal clogging when using Teflon tape for sealing within a nitrous delivery system. The second type of fitting you'll commonly find in an NOS kit is called an Army-Navy fitting and is more commonly referred to as an AN fitting. AN fittings are easily identified by the rounded or beveled shape of the male end and the freely turning nut and flared edge inside the female end of the connector. With an AN fitting, no sealer is needed because the angled faces of the mating surfaces of the connectors will seal out leaks when properly tightened. The last type of connector you may find in some NOS kits is called a compression fitting. There is a compression body, a ferrule sealing ring, and a tightening nut. All these pieces compress together to seal against a tube exterior in hardline plumbing applications.
Now that you have a better understanding of sealing methods, let's seal and install all of the NPT threads related to the nitrous solenoid. Your nitrous line has already been run and has a female AN fitting at the end. In your kit, find the nitrous filter. It's a blue anodized fitting with a rounded AN fitting on one end and an NPT thread on the other end. The NPT threads will get a coating of Teflon paste. Make sure to work a nice even amount in between the threads as best you can. Be especially careful not to clog the filter screen on the NPT side of the fitting. After an even coat, wipe any excess that is around the filter screen or the immediate edge to prevent sealant from entering the solenoid. Now, for all kit types, locate the IN label on the nitrous solenoid and thread the nitrous filter fitting into that port. Snug it up by hand and then clamp the solenoid in a bench vise to hold it steady for tightening. With the solenoid clamped, tighten the filter with a wrench until it feels like it's cinched up nice and tight. This is the reason for the bench vise. It's more difficult to tighten them properly when holding the solenoid only in your hands. Again, turn to your kit and find the nitrous feed line intended to travel from your nitrous solenoid to the discharge nozzle. Kits with foggers will have a stainless steel braided hose with an NPT fitting at one end. Kits with plates or spray bars may have a hose or hardline tube with a compression fitting. With compression fittings, you only need the body of the fitting and can put aside the nut and compression ferrule. Direct port kits and their fittings were discussed in the direct port and nozzle fitting section previously. Next up, for single nozzle and plate style kits, seal the threads on the NPT fittings that will thread into the port on the nitrous solenoid that is labeled out. The solenoid should go back into the bench vise in order to tighten the nitrous feed line or fitting. When it's set, pull out the solenoid and let's look at the bracket mounting holes at the bottom of the solenoid. For owners of dry kits, you'll need to seal the threads of the nitrous T connector and screw it into the out port of the first solenoid. Now hand thread the in port of the second nitrous solenoid onto the other side of that same T connector. Double check the assembly and be sure the nitrous filter is going in to the first solenoid, out to the T, and then in to the second solenoid. Clamp one of the solenoids in a vise and tighten the T while threading that solenoid with a wrench. Now flip so the other solenoid is pinched in the vise and tighten the T a couple of turns into that solenoid. Set the solenoid bottoms parallel to one another and consider the exit position of the center of the T fitting. Your nitrous regulator needs to thread into the T later. Now hold the bracket to the solenoid bottoms to check for hole alignment. Now at this point, it goes the same for all other types of kits. If you hold your bracket up to a single solenoid and you see no bolt holes, flip the bracket over and you should have access to the holes and be able to thread in the mounting bolts. On the dual solenoid dry kits, if the holes aren't accessible for both solenoids, you should only have to thread in the adapter T maybe one turn for each solenoid. After the extra turns, the holes should be all accessible. Now your solenoid assembly is ready for install in the vehicle. Using your mounting brackets and bending, twisting, or adding bolts as needed, fix the solenoid into the permanent mounting position that you chose before. Most people will just be able to simply mount the solenoid with an existing underhood bolt. For some plate-style kits, the solenoids will be mounted on either side of the carburetor or throttle body unit. These installs may also be mounted on accessory brackets that locate the solenoids symmetrically on either side of the induction assembly. Specifics for the direct port kit solenoid install recommendations were previously discussed in the direct port nozzle installation section. At this point, the nitrous solenoids of any style kit should be sealed and secured in place. Because you've already thought about the hose distances and locations of the solenoids when you did the nozzle installation, all you need to do now is connect the nitrous feed lines. The nitrous feed line running from the bottle should be near your filter entry point. Remove the plastic wrap or end covering and thread it into place on the nitrous filter. If the line was not covered, you may want to connect it to a full bottle and wrap the end in a rag, then quickly open and then close the bottle to purge the line of any debris before connecting to the solenoid filter. One wrench should hold the filter fitting steady while another wrench tightens the nitrous bottle feed line in place to the solenoid. For multi-port kits, the bottle feed line should connect to the nitrous Y adapter and no sealant is needed for AN fittings. Each side of the Y adapter should feed one nitrous solenoid. Now we need to finish the connection from the solenoid to the discharge nozzle. For the dry and wet fogger kits, you need to pick the appropriate nitrous tuning jet from your kit and install it to the dry kit fan spray nozzle or the nitrous port of your wet kit soft plume nozzle. No sealers are ever used on the jets or the interior of the color anodized nozzle fittings. For the hose type lines, hold the nozzle steady with one wrench and tighten the AN fitting nut with a separate wrench for a good seal that won't alter your previous nozzle alignment. For plate discharge style kits, the nitrous jet will install into the blue anodized compression fitting in the plate. Again, no sealant is to be used on the jet or in the blue nitrous fitting. Hose type feeds can be tightened with two wrenches as described. Kits with hard line feeds should remain hand tight in the plate for the moment. With the hard line loose in the plate, position the line under the compression fitting for marking. Inside the compression fitting, there's a machined bottom stop. When the line is inserted into the fitting, it's only going to travel so far. So let's mark that point. Basically, the stopping point is in line with the end of the threads of the compression fitting. With the pre-bent hard line hand tightened to the plate with a jet, use a straight edge to make a mark on the tube directly down from the end of the compression threads. Now remove the tube and use a tubing cutter to cleanly cut the tube at that mark. After the cutter has shortened the tube, use a reamer to clean out the inside and any loose shavings from the inner diameter of the tube. Now grab the compression nut and ferrule and slide the nut on first and then the ferrule. Recheck that the jet is still in place and install the tube to its permanent position. Hand tight on the anodized nut first, and then, while pressing the tube against the inside of the compression fitting, slide the ferrule in place, and then the nut that gets hand tightened. Hold the fitting with a wrench, and with another wrench, tighten up the compression nut while still applying light pressure to hold the tube against the stop inside the fitting. You should not be able to pull the tube out of the fitting when it's tightened properly. Now for all kit types, the plumbing for the nitrous side of the system should be complete all the way from the bottle through the nitrous solenoid and to the discharge nozzle.